It's called Victoria's Riviera. While that name might conjure images of baguettes, gigolos and facelifts, what it really refers to is this. Just a few hours' drive from Melbourne, East Gippsland has a geography and weather comparable to the south of France. Wind blows cold onto mountains, precipitates into snow, loses its coolness and blows warm down to nearby sea. For the visitor, that means a series of bizarrely different environments, from chilling damp plateau to balmy beaches, from lush temperate rainforest to arid bush. And in the midst of all that, 400 square kilometres of this.
Raise the mizzen!
He's got the easy one.
Hold it.
A bit more slack? Gippsland's lakes are what have made this area famous. They're where most visitors begin and usually end their stay.
Oh, it would take you months, really. There are lots of places I've never been to. The area is bigger than the Sydney Harbour.
Even so, they're only a small part of the area. Our guide on this trip, Paul Hickman Harris, has promised to show us three very different holiday environments in just 3 days.
You can go from an ocean coastal environment in 1 day. You can spend the next day up in a mountain environment. You can actually get up to the snow. There's just so many different environments. It's unbelievable.
Day one, of course, is spent on the lakes, on board a boat called the Spray. It's owned by former schoolteacher Bob Dack, who charters it from $15 per person.
The story is that it's one of the early replicas of Captain Joshua Slocum's Spray. And Slocum was the first man to sail around the world alone in the 1890s. And on his way around the world, he came into Port Phillip Bay, and the fellow who had this boat built eventually went on board Slocum's original Spray, met him, loved the boat, and close on 30 years later, had this one built.
Looks like an interesting place to sail. There's so much variety here.
It is. It's fantastic. You never get out of sight of land either.
But within 1 hour's sailing, you've lost sight of people. Outside of summer, 90 Mile Beach, the world's longest uninterrupted beach, can seem almost deserted. At Sperm Whale Head, picnickers can be outnumbered by animals. These are all familiar tourist haunts. Day two will take us further. Trapped by the mountains behind, it's one of the driest parts of Victoria.
It only gets an annual rainfall of about 4 inches a year.
And yet it's dotted with waterfalls, some of them 40 metres tall. Part of a river system running down to the Snowy that's carved a gorge hundreds of metres into the rock.
There's quite a contrast between here and the Snowy. Here we've got water that's rushing over rocks. There's numerous waterfalls all the way down this valley. Further down, where it joins the Snowy, it widens out into a much bigger river. And that's a fabulous area for rafting. It's very steep-sided, and we'll be getting a bit of a taste of that this afternoon.
Rain and sometimes snow first lands.
As you can see, the Waratahs are in flower at the moment, and they're quite beautiful. They're generic to this area, or to the area of East Gippsland, and they're quite different from the waratahs, which are the natural emblem in New South Wales. They grow up to about 40 feet or 12 metres.
Of everything on the plateau, it's here where the trip ends that comes as the greatest surprise. Temperate rainforests within walking distance of the snow line.
This one here is a sassafras. As you can see now with the sun out a little bit, the filtered light underneath gives rise to all the fern growth underneath in the understory. I reckon this particular specimen here would have to be 400 years old. It's just great.
But it's interesting, I've only heard stories like rainforests are in Queensland. Mm. I didn't know in Victoria we had them.
Yes. I love these mosses. Look, that's actually in bloom now. And the mosses and the lichens, so much of it. Look at it up there. Beautiful.
These are not widely travelled places, although each area, each environment, is within a day's drive of Melbourne.
In the cave.
It was snowing the day before yesterday up here.
How?
It's snowing up here.
We've been whitewater rafting.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was good. That was probably
mountain climbing.
Good fun.
Swimming in the ocean.
Walking through the forest. Maybe. I think a lot of people in Melbourne just don't know that this part exists. East Gippsland.
The variety is great. Different climate, different rainfall areas, different scenery. It's just magic place.